And I just Swiss round.
And joining me here is Churro.
Hello.
Alright, we're jumping right into it. G-Man going Sonic against that guy.
How long has G-Man been playing Sonic?
It started last week.
Yeah.
Well, it happened, the story behind this is, G-Man's got a good friend. That guy was going through some rough times. He, as a favor, G-Man offered, I'll go a character you want me to go, all bracket.
Oh, wow.
And so that guy picked Sonic for G-Man. G-Man came out and got crazy good results with the character he's never played before.
That's insane.
And so now he's adding Sonic to his official roster because I think it fits his playstyle well and he performs well.
Yeah,
so.
I think he does too. Sonic can do a lot of mix-ups and I think that's what G-Man likes to do.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Well, that's awesome. I applaud you, G-Man.
Yeah, and so that guy is getting some back throws, keeping Sonic off stage. Sonic's really hard to edge guard, though.
Yeah, he sure is.
He's just got, like, you know...
He's got a lot of horizontal aerial movement. If he gets near the stage, he can side B back on really fast.
Yeah,
he goes really high, really fast.
Basically, he's just got, like, a Christmas list of, like, things he can do to get back to the stage.
Yeah. He can down air to the depths.
Alright, and what we saw right there is the custom he's using, the berries, the side B berries on this particular Sonic.
Yeah, and in case you didn't know, when someone's buried, they actually take less knockback. So
not
that's
aware.
Why that forward smash didn't kill Mario there.
Yeah, I was actually surprised. I expected G-Man to go for an up smash, because up smash is a little bit of a... Oh, well, that one's gonna work as well, though. But yeah, up smash is usually a little bit better for catching those grounded opponents, if you like, especially because you can get them if they happen to pop out.
Right, and
And Sonic's up smash is maybe even a better killing smash than his forward one, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty strong. I think forward smash is stronger, but smash roll has kind of close in, so...
Yeah.
And Mario's a little bit
slow. It's average-ish. It's, like, not high, but it's not low, either.
Yeah. In between, at the low.
Yeah. Part of the reason everyone likes to start here, it's a very neutral stage.
Yeah.
Oh, nice use of the platform to recover there.
Yeah,
oh,
great. Wow.
That guy calls him out.
Yeah, I think he saw that side B coming and he went for the up smash and it worked.
Yeah.
Mario's up smash is invincible when he does it at the head.
Yeah, he's like, you can't ground but this.
Yeah.
Another interesting thing about this particular custom that G-Man's using is, as you see, it has a very steep and not very wide arc to it as it goes relative to the normal Sonic move, which means you have to use it closer. But one of the other perks of it, though, is that the whole time he's going up, as soon as he hits the whole time before he hits the apex of that rise, he's actually invincible the same way ZSS is during her flip kick.
Yeah, I didn't know that. That's
yep.
Very interesting. Oh, I think he caught Mario's jump there.
That yeah, that
it.
Was...
Wow, that's...
Wow, yeah.
What a way to go.
A really solid fair. I was actually surprised it didn't kill off the boundary. That was good DI on that guy's part, but still too far out to recover.
Mario's recovery pretty good, kind of in the middle.
So game one goes to G-Man.
Just like everything with Mario, so...
Yeah.
G-Man takes it.
He's the middleman, the average guy, the all-arounder.
That's right. That's
he's that guy.
He is that guy. Great way to put it. Wow. So Mario, that guy taking G-Man to Omega Onet, or Onet.
This is one of that guy's favorite Omegas, I believe. Just because I know he's taken me here at least once.
So this is an Omega that has walls all the way straight down, and I believe you can wall jump on this.
Yep, you can wall jump on any Omega with walls straight down.
Nope. How about Omega Kalos? You can. And
you definitely can wall jump on Kalos.
Nope, not on Omega. I promise.
Okay.
Also, Omega Pac-Man that has walls that you cannot...
Who goes to Omega Pac-Man?
That's the most ugly stage I've ever seen, but just saying, I promise.
Alright, I'll test it out later, because I'm not sure I trust you.
Well.
But anyways, you can wall jump here, and both these characters can wall jump.
Oh, wow.
But
was fantastic.
Wow, so it looks like G-Man's going to be careful with that approach, because if that guy times it out right, he can lock the G-Man into a side B off the edge like that.
Yeah. Jeez.
I wonder, I never touch Sonic. He's like one of my least favorite characters, to be honest.
Yeah.
So like, I have very little idea on how to control a lot of his moves he's using. So I'm not sure how you break out of the side B, but I think when you go off the edge, it must be hard to do, because G-Man definitely failed.
Yeah.
I guess what I'm wondering is whether or not the cape caused that, or if you actually, under normal circumstances, can't get out of your side B when you go off the edge like that.
I think normally you just have a lot of downtime. Like, if he was off the...
there's that up smash.
Tomorrow. But if he were off stage and he's side B, he'd just go pretty much all the way down. I think all your only hope, if you miss the stage with the side B off stage, is just mash and jump as fast as you can and hope you're up there.
Alright. So that's what we saw there. J-Man doing a good job of burying that guy. We've seen it happen, you know, like 7 or 8 times a set now.
Yeah, that quick burial, the forward smash did like 20%.
Mm-hmm. Catching himself back up. That guy's trying to keep the lead that he got with that really, really stellar cape.
Working so far. He's trying to get another cape there.
Yeah, Sonic's a hard character to keep out, though. The epitome of Rushdown characters.
Right.
The only character I think of as more of a Rushdown character than Sonic is maybe Captain Falcon.
Yeah. Yeah. That guy likes to opt for the fast fireball on Mario. Wow.
Repeat of game one. He calls out that side B and he gets it with the up smash.
Yeah.
Game two going to that guy.
One. You can say that guy likes to opt for the fast fireball. Personally, I play Mario also. I like to see his normal fireball.
Mm-hmm.
They definitely both have their ups and downs. I like normal fireball because it's so easy. It has the potential to gimp people. Just travels straight down. You just jump up and cover your higher options and shoot fireball down. Sometimes you catch a jump and then done. So that's what I like to use.
We're getting Sonic music. We're probably going to be in the Mega Windy Hill Zone. Reach for the stars, people.
I can do it.
So, if for my own part, I know that the fast fireballs, on the other hand, their pro is that you can get lots of damage in. Of course, they're very little damage per hit, but pretty much everything you do when it's... excuse me there. When you throw them out too far to follow up with anything else, you can just throw a few fast fireballs and get a little bit extra damage.
Right, they only do 1% to 3% based on distance, but their cooldown is very low, very hard to punish. But Sonic might be fast enough to get.
Yeah, one other perk of the fast fireballs. Yeah, good back here there.
Good cape to keep Sonic away. Like, this cape also gives Mario much more of a little jump.
Yeah, kind of like Mewtwo's confusion or something.
It actually really helps.
Yeah. Oh, wow. G-Man's spot on with these back airs right now. So, one... there we go, the back airs, yeah.
Just scaring him, spooking him.
That guy's got a... gotta make some adjustments, gotta figure this out. G-Man's figured it out. Ooh, nice.
This is good up B. Kind of risky, but it pays out there. Quick 7 or 8 damage.
Alright.
So the one final perk of those fast fireballs is they are actually a jab reset.
Are you guys fighting?
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah, I think
and jab reset projectiles are very nice.
I wasn't sure that they did that normal fireballs, they also don't jab as fast.
Alright. Ooh, G-Man gets that grab. That guy needs to take a stock soon. G-Man's starting to build up a pretty solid lead at this point. Let's see if he can get an edge guard. And
I think I kind of skipped. I need to find the right place.
Ooh, that guy's juggling. It's looking like a... oh, okay, never mind. I wonder if that's the throw that G-Man actually wants. He must be going for more of a combo-heavy follow-up.
I just went to the wrong area.
Oh! G-Man covers that guy's landing option. He gets that up smash, and G-Man takes the set 2-1 with a very convincing 2-stock finish. However, that guy did do a really good job in the first 2 games, so...